Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you major news developments from around the world. Our headlines: at least 2 killed during protests held on Afghanistan's Independence Day. 500,000 people in need of emergency aid in Haiti as rescue efforts continue. Indigenous communities and workers across Brazil mobilize against Bolsonaro. Nabisco workers go on strike for a fair contract across 3 states in the US. In our first story, protests and small demonstrations were held in several Afghan cities on August 19th. The day marked the country's 102nd Independence Day. However, at least 2 people were killed after the Taliban opened fire during a protest in Asadabad. 2 people were also injured during a protest in Jalalabad. People marched in the capital of Kabul carrying the black, red and green flag. Meanwhile, a 24-hour curfew was imposed in Khost. Taliban and NATO officials have stated that at least 12 people have been killed in and around Kabul airport. Afghan civilians have continued to gather in the area in hopes of being evacuated. Meanwhile, the World Food Programme has stated that 14 million Afghans are facing severe hunger. The war, coupled with a major drought and the COVID-19 pandemic, has made conditions much worse. Over 40% of crops have been destroyed and livestock has perished. Meanwhile, an estimated 400,000 people have been displaced this year so far. In our next story, at least 500,000 people across Haiti are in need of emergency assistance. With rescue efforts still ongoing, the death toll as of August 18 stands at 1,941. Haitian officials have stated that over 12,000 people may have been injured. Meanwhile, search and rescue teams have been able to save at least 34 people. As per the UNOCHA, the earthquake destroyed 61,000 homes. 137,000 families in South Granasse and Nepis departments have been affected. 20 health facilities have been damaged and 4 have been destroyed. The delivery of aid has been restricted due to flooding and rain, but also due to armed groups. Here is a video feature of the situation in Haiti. We now go to Brazil, where indigenous communities and workers are mobilizing against President Jair Bolsonaro. A 24-hour general strike was observed across the country on August 18th. The call was issued by the Unified Workers Center, or CUT, to protest Reform PEC 32. The amendment will allow the government to privatize public services. These include health, education and security, among others. The government is also pushing labor reform MP 1045. The CUT says that this will reduce the value of wages and labor rights. It will also restrict union action and access to the labor court. Thousands of civil servants, teachers and workers took to the streets on Wednesday. The strike took place just as indigenous groups are gearing up for the Struggle for Life protest. Deforestation in the Amazon forest has increased by over 85% under Jair Bolsonaro. Invasions of indigenous lands grew by 135% in 2019 alone. During Bolsonaro's first year in office, invasions in the Ituna Itata land grew by 650%. Indigenous communities have also faced violent attacks by illegal gold miners. An estimated 4,470 illegal mining sites are located in the Amazon. At least 20,000 illegal miners are present in the indigenous Yanomami Reserve alone. The pollution from mining has also led to the contamination of indigenous lands. Bolsonaro and his allies have introduced bills that will open protected land to agribusiness and mining. They have also pushed legislation that will deny recognition of indigenous peoples and eliminate sovereign territorial rights. The Articulation of Indigenous People of Brazil has filed a lawsuit against Bolsonaro in the ICC. He has been denounced for crimes against humanity and genocide. And for our final story, we go to the US, where workers at the Nabisco food company are on strike for a fair contract. Around 200 workers at a bakery in Portland City walked out on August 10th. They were all organized by the Bakery, Confectionery, Tobacco Workers and Grain Millers Union. The strike has spread to the states of Colorado and Virginia, with hundreds of workers now protesting. All have identical contracts which expired earlier this year. Employees say that they have been forced to work 12 to 16 hour shifts, often 6 to 7 days a week. Meanwhile, Nabisco made $6.64 billion in revenue last year. The company is trying to implement an alternative work week. This would eliminate the overtime pay for working on weekends or beyond 8-hour shifts. Instead, workers would be paid regular rates till they hit 40 hours. A worker told Huffington Post that some could stand to lose $10,000 a year. Nabisco has also proposed a two-tier healthcare system. Under this, new hires will receive less benefits. The company had already cut down pensions of workers and retirees in 2018. It recently also shut down food processing facilities in Georgia and New Jersey. 1,000 unionized workers lost their jobs. That's all we have time for today. We'll be back tomorrow with more news from around the world. Until then, keep watching People's Dispatch.